Next, let us discuss about the Boolean instructions. We had seen the 8051 is having the single bit handling capability. That means you can deal with the single bit, set or reset the bit. So here are the instructions for that. CLRC, clear carry flag. If it is 1, it will become 0. Next is the clear any particular bit. Then set bit C means carry flag will be set. Here setting any particular bit. CPLC is nothing but the complement the carry flag. That means if the previous carry is 0, now it will become 1. If it is 1, now it will become 0. And then CPL bit, complementing the individual bit, that is possible using this. Here the logical operations with the single bit, ANL for ANDing operation, then ORL for OR operation. Moving the single bit in the carry or from carry to that bit position. Next, these are the jump instructions. Jump on carry to the address specified in the instruction. Jump if no carry. Jump if bit set. Jump if not bit set. Jump if bit carry to the specified address. That are the Boolean instructions in the 8051. Now the last group is nothing but the program branching instructions. Normally the instructions are executed in sequence, but during the branch instruction the execution transfers from current memory location to some different memory location. Let us discuss about those branching instructions. Absolute call. Mainly there are two types of calls, long call and the absolute call. That means the range. Here 11 address bits are used, here 16 address bits are used. In case of absolute call, the jump is within 2k forward or backward. However, in the long call, it is the total 64k forward or backward jump is possible in case of long call. Call instructions are always in pairs with the return. Whenever there is a call, there is always a return. So RET is the instruction used for that, returning from the procedures. RETI is used for returning from the interrupt procedures. Then similar to the call instructions, there are jump instructions. Absolute jump, long jump, and one more, short jump. Here again total 11 address lines are used in case of absolute jump. So the jump is within the 2 kilobytes range. In case of long jump, total 16 address lines are used. So the jump possible is 64k. Here short jump, a relative address, that is possible for about 128 bytes forward or backward jump. So those are the jump and call instructions, which are called as the program branching instructions in the 8051 microcontroller. The major difference between the jump and call is that in case of call, there is always return. However, in case of jump instructions, those are unconditional jump instructions. That means the program, once transferred to the address location, it will never come back. That is about the program branching instructions in the 805 mode. Here are the few more that includes jump at A plus DPTR. The address is summation of accumulator contents and the DPTR contents, and then it will go to that address location. Jump on 0. These are the conditional branch instructions. Jump if not 0. Earlier we discussed are the unconditional. Here certain condition is tested, say 0 flag is tested, or a carry flag is tested, or parity flag is tested, like that. Now here compare and jump if not equal. So the two numbers are compared, and if they are not equal, then the program will transfer to the address location specified in the instruction. Next, again you can find compare and jump if not equal. Here accumulator contents are directly compared with the immediate number specified in the instruction. If not equal, then go to the relative address. Here register contents, you can use R0 to R7 over here, that are compared. Here indirect addressing mode, where only R0 or R1 can be used. So the number stored specified using the R0 or R1, that is compared with the immediate data, and depending on that the decision is taken, if not equal, then go to the relative address. Next, DJNZ, decrement and jump if not 0. Here the two operations are done in a single instruction. That will first decrement the register contents and then compare. If it is not 0, then it will go to the relative address. Here DJNZ, direct addressing is used, and last there is a NOP, that stands for no operation. This NOP is basically used for inserting delays. So those are the conditional branch instructions in the 8051. What is the difference between the conditional and unconditional? In conditional branch instruction, some condition is tested, and depending on that the decision is taken whether to take the branch or not. However, in case of unconditional branch instructions, irrespectively it will go to the address location specified in the instruction. That's all about the instruction set of the 8051 microcontroller. Instruction set is very important. Once you learn the instruction set, it is easy to write the programs using the assembly language in the 8051 microcontroller. Thank you.